Okay, it's working now. Hello, everybody. I am Hole Puncher, and welcome to the weekly podcast. And here I am joined by, how would you like to be referred?
The bacon-wrapped corn dog.
The bacon-wrapped corn dog.
That's what my profile picture is.
Can I just call you, like, Dave?
Sure.
Okay, Dave.
That works.
All right, Dave. So, why don't you tell everybody what we're going to do, seeing as how you've never been on this podcast before. You should be the first one to do this.
I'm not exactly sure exactly what we're going to do, but as far as I know, we're going to talk about Star Wars. At some point, we're going to make fun of Jar Jar Binks. We are...
The trailer.
Oh, yeah. The X-Men trailer. And I will probably take a bathroom break while he talks about the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle trailer.
I'm certain that will all happen.
We have this really well planned out. I have thorough notes right here.
Yeah. Don't lie. Don't lie.
I don't have any notes at all. I'm winging this. I have a cat sitting next to me, so I think that's just as good.
I didn't know you have a cat.
Yeah, he's sitting right next to me. He's taking a nap.
Cool.
Anyway.
So anyway, let's talk about the X-Men trailer.
Okay. Right?
So this is going to be a thorough, in-depth analysis.
I only watched it once.
I know. I only watched it like twice, so.
Okay.
We're totally.
So you're only a little bit ahead of me.
Yeah. Okay, so what were your just initial thoughts of it?
Intense.
Okay.
Large lack of Hugh Jackman.
That's right. I didn't think about that. Where is he gonna be?
Where is he?
Is he in this movie?
He's supposed to be in it.
I didn't even realize that, actually.
People watch X-Men for Hugh Jackman.
Yeah, they really do.
Because he's like really cool.
Yeah.
I don't know. I thought he was supposed to be in this one. I'm on IMDb right now, and I'm not seeing anything.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Wow. Is he not in this?
I thought this was, or maybe it's the next Wolverine movie that's supposed to be his last. Maybe this one.
Nobody cares about the Wolverine movies, though. They're dumb.
Yeah. If you're gonna, if you decide what's Hugh Jackman's last movie is Wolverine gonna be, why would you be like the next Wolverine movie? No.
Did anybody actually watch X-Men Origins Wolverine?
It was
so disappointing.
Anyway, so when I first saw the trailer, I was kind of like, this looks like a cartoon. Did you think that? Look at that. The ending of the trailer looks insane. Because it's like
bald James McAvoy you talk about?
That and the fact that like
James McAvoy without hair
is going through like a ghost dimension, which I assume is Cerebro. And
yeah.
And, you know, everybody's, like, shooting fire out of their hands. And everything's exploding. And there's just storms happening and lasers and, you know.
Yeah, it's intense.
What did you – okay, I heard somebody mention this, but I didn't even think about this, that Mystique isn't blue at any point in this trailer.
Yeah.
What do you think that means?
Do you think
– is she all, like, humanity rocks?
Well – I think at some point they're going to have her turn into Wolverine just so they can get Hugh Jackman some more screen time.
Oh, you think so? That would be interesting. That would be very interesting. But so what did you think about the fact that I thought it was ridiculous sort of that they just show Professor Xavier bald at the end of the trailer? Like that's some huge reveal. Like
it is.
Is it?
I don't know. You know what I read?
What?
That when he actually got the part of Professor X, he shaved his head only to find out that they wanted him to have hair.
Really? In First Class?
In First Class, he shaved his head when he got the part, and then they're like, hey, we want you to have hair. And he's like, oh, great.
Oh, so he
just had to wear hair extensions for that movie.
Oh, my gosh. He really did shave his head, though, for this, though. So that makes sense why he was so willing. Because he's like, finally, the moment when I can... you know, not have hair.
Yeah. Anyway.
Hi, Ian.
Other thoughts?
Other thoughts. Apocalypse was in this trailer. We got to see
quite a bit.
Yeah.
I mean, he did a lot. Can we talk about the horsemen?
Yeah, sure. Okay, so the four horsemen, I tried to pause the trailer to see who all of them were. So there's Storm, Magneto. Psylocke.
As Michael Fassbender.
Yes, just Michael Fassbender, glorious actor. Psylocke.
Great hair.
Yes.
Really.
Psylocke. And Archangel.
Yeah, my
So.
question. Well, also there's another Quicksilver scene,
Yeah, okay, so
which
I heard someone say
already
that,
looking forward
well,
to.
apparently one of the like special effects designers said that this Quicksilver scene is like 10 times more complicated than the last one.
The last one was just awesome.
And apparently this one took them a month to film it. Just the one scene. So this is going
Well, I
it's going
mean,
to
like, he
be
gotta do well. I would take him as my horseman. I want him. I want Wolverine.
Yeah.
I mean,
Also Mystique. Wouldn't Mystique be useful? Because I saw I there was
think,
there was there was
yeah.
one
Maybe
point
like Rogue.
well there
I think
was
Rogue could be
yeah
kind of
or oh
handy.
oh oh what about
Like, kill
Cyclops?
people.
Cyclops though would be good. Because
Cyclops,
they get their powers increased whenever they become the Four Horsemen. So like,
he could possibly control.
well, he could also, I don't know, shoot lasers out of his hands too. Shoot more lasers.
Yeah, just shoot
Okay,
lasers everywhere.
I gotta say, I thought it was okay. This was really weird for me, but during that trailer, when Cyclops says most of us don't even know how to control our powers, and then Mystique says, we'll deal with it or whatever.
Yeah.
I was thinking like,
Suck it up.
yeah, but I was thinking like, who, what, how far gone are they? Like how deep, like how bad is it that they need like all teenagers? Like that, because
Well,
okay, because Jean Grey, Nightcrawler, and Cyclops are all teenagers at this point. So why the heck is it that they ha and why is Mystique leading them? That's another thing I didn't get.
Here's well, Professor X is probably embarrassed because he's bald. Hugh Jackman is busy filming the other third Wolverine movie that nobody cares about.
That's true.
So, I mean, those are your two best options, and they're gone. All the other cool people are horsemen at this time.
Yeah, Magneto. Dude, it
Like,
would have been cool. How cool would it have
also,
been
the main
if.
reason is because Jennifer Lawrence is popular and they have to give her screen time.
That's very true. That
I'm just gonna
that's
put
the
that out there.
and that's the total the reason that she's ever not blue in this entire
Yeah.
series.
People are really into Jennifer Lawrence giving motivational speeches.
Yeah.
Like, even more so than Shia LaBeouf.
Yeah.
Which I'd like to get him involved in X-Men as well, but.
Who would he be? Which X-Men would he be? Wolverine.
Well, yeah, I mean, Hugh Jackman, yeah. I think I would
He
take
would, you know
him.
who he would be good as? He would be a
Who?
good Juggernaut.
With like a CGI muscles or something?
Well, I mean, yeah, I'm assuming so, but like
I'd take him as I could actually seriously see him as like a Cyclops, but I still want him to play Jimmy Olsen. Like, he still is Jimmy Olsen.
that would be really
He
cool
is
if he was
literally
Jimmy
Jimmy
Olsen.
Olsen.
He is in every way Jimmy Olsen. Although I'm
He
pretty sure
is.
Jimmy Olsen's already cast in Batman v Superman, so that's sad.
It's probably just a cover up. It's probably Shia LaBeouf.
Yeah.
Here's
Okay.
my thing.
Okay.
Big reveal at the end of the movie. Apocalypse takes off a mask and it's Stan Lee. What would that lead to?
So you're saying that at the end he takes off his face and it's a mask,
And it's is
underneath that
Stan
is
Lee.
Stan Lee.
And he's just been controlling this whole situation.
I don't know what to. I think I would literally just die instantly because I wouldn't
In the
know.
theater.
Yeah, because I wouldn't know what was real anymore. I'd just be like, okay, goodbye.
You completely rewrite the game. Like, you could do literally anything with a superhero movie after that.
Oh yeah, like you can go anywhere now.
So, we didn't see him in the trailer, but Alex Summers is supposed to be in it.
Yeah, okay,
Havoc.
wasn't that the dude that Professor Xavier was with when they were talking to Moira McTaggart about Apocalypse? Who's the
Was
blonde
it?
guy with, or was that Angel, you think? Maybe that was Angel.
I'm not sure. They're both blonde.
Yeah, there's
Could have been either one, but
so many blonde
Havoc.
people in these movies.
He was, yeah, true. Havoc was one of my favorite parts of First Class, though, so I want to see more of him.
He was really cool. I'm excited to see Nightcrawler because Nightcrawler is one of my favorite characters in
And
X-Men.
he's played by the kid from Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, which is a great movie.
Which kid is that? Is that the son of?
Cody Smit-McPhee.
Okay. That's the actor. That's like the son of the main. That's the son of the
son of the main guy. Okay, okay. I like that movie.
Yeah, that was a really good movie. You know what's funny is at the end of that movie, when I walked out of the theater, I told someone, the next one that they're gonna make is gonna be called War of the Planet of the Apes, and I was completely right.
Really?
Yeah, I was.
I feel like they should have switched to the names because I feel like the first one is more of the Dawn, and the second one is more of a Rise, but. They couldn't know that.
I think the that is a good point. Although I think the point, well, you're actually completely right, because it would be the Dawn, and then the other one would be the Rise, because that's when they actually, you know, have conquered a lot of the world and stuff.
Yeah, like I feel like the Rise more in that one.
But so what else do we see in the trailer that was eye catching? The part where Professor Xavier's eyes turn completely black and go, "I've never felt power like this before."
Yeah, that was interesting. And yeah, you know, I'm kind of like not sure. I watched this trailer. I think it was at 3 a.m.
Oh, okay.
So I don't know.
Okay, this part really intrigued me. The part where Professor Xavier is standing up and punches Apocalypse in the face, and then Apocalypse grows to like 30 feet tall.
That was more than 30 feet.
No, probably.
He was big.
Probably.
He was a big dude.
But, okay, that must be, like, that's either a dream or it's, like, a psychic battle, right?
Like, Professor X is always getting in psychic battles.
He always is. He needs to get
in. It's just, like, his, like, favorite thing to do. It's, like, a hobby.
I heard somebody in a video, though, talking about how in every X-Men movie, they have to cripple Professor Xavier because he's too powerful. Otherwise he can just defeat everyone by putting them to sleep, you know?
You know, in the old comic books in, like, the 60s, he was a teenager who had a crush on Jean Grey, so let that sink in.
Well, okay, I've heard of that. How old was he when...
Nobody knows.
Nobody knows. But, like, was he, like, an adult at that point, or was it, like, he was a...
We'll ask Stan Lee after he reveals himself as Apocalypse.
Yeah, because he knows everything. He's been planning all
this. He does.
He's been planning
he's in charge of everything.
From the beginning.
Always Stan Lee. We find out after this, Stan Lee is every single character in the Marvel
Universe. And everyone just takes off a Mission Impossible style mask. They all take off a mask,
and it's Stan Lee. It's just an army of thousands of Stan Lees.
Yeah, and then they all yell, "Excelsior!"
Yes, exactly. Then I take off a mask and I'm Stan Lee, and everybody gets confused.
Yep. Could you imagine if that happened? What would the world be?
I don't know.
Oh, by the way, did you watch Jessica Jones? Just out of curiosity.
No, I didn't.
You should watch it. It's good.
It's like, I don't know.
I mean, it's like a detective show, so I mean, it depends on if you like detective shows, because if you don't, then...
I do. I like good detective shows.
It's a good detective show. There's just a lot of, we gotta find evidence on this guy, and we gotta go this way, and whoops, that didn't work, and then, you know.
Did you ever watch this TV show, Psych?
Yes, great show.
Great show. I really enjoy the way that they do the detective part of that, with like his seeing everything.
Yeah, and just being very observant.
They did that at the beginning of The Flash, and I wish they had done more of that, because I thought that was really cool.
That's very true, isn't it? That he kind of
like, the
was
first episode,
really
he was totally a detective, and after that, they just kind of let that fall off.
I assume the copyrights came in, and like, no, that's Batman. Leave the detective stuff to Batman, and you don't...
But I mean, like, they're the same... Batman doesn't even exist.
Yeah, I know.
Takes off a mask, it's Stan Lee.
It's like off a mask, it's Bruce Wayne. Flash takes off a mask and he's like, "I actually have serious faith in Batman." Yeah. Anyway,
X-Men.
Yeah. Archangel looks pretty cool, doesn't he?
Yes.
He was
shooting something out of his wings. He was shooting little feathers.
Little metal feathers. Yep.
Little metal feathers. I feel like I've seen that
metal
before.
Metal Feather should be the name of a heavy metal band. Metal
Feather. The bad guy in Kung Fu Panda 2 did that as well.
Did he?
Yeah.
Huh.
He was a peacock and he shot pointy little feathers.
Dude, I completely forgot that there was a Kung Fu Panda 2.
They're making a third one.
I don't get why.
They didn't.
Is it because Jack Black has nothing else to do?
Yeah, like, he just has no life. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. I kind of want to see
we
it.
We don't actually mean that, Mr. Jack Black. We're just...
If, in case he listens to this podcast,
which he never
we love
will.
You. We love you. You're talented and funny.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
That's out of the way.
Okay. You want to just move on to Star Wars, or is there anything else that you can think of from the trailer that was intriguing to you?
No.
Okay.
But, I mean, Star Wars is
this,
cool.
This trailer was sort of just... Like, it wasn't really a whole lot new that I didn't expect... You know, like,
yeah.
Like I knew.
I just
like,
wanted to like, see more Wolverine. Like,
yeah.
Where was Wolverine?
But, you know, like, we knew Apocalypse was going to be in this. We knew, you know, Psylocke was going to be in it. We knew, you know, he's going to have the Four Horsemen. And, you know, like, we knew most of that stuff. It kind of just showed stuff that we just expected out of the movie. You know, like, it wasn't like there was, you know. Although that's kind of good. They didn't show a big reveal or anything. The big reveal was only bald Professor Xavier.
Which we knew that was going to happen at some point.
Yeah.
Get
this. I heard apparently I'm not sure if it was the director or somebody else on the crew said that the reason, or it might have been James McAvoy himself.
It was James McAvoy.
He said that the reason that happens, that he becomes bald, is that something so tragic or just devastating happens to him that he rips out all of his hair.
I know what it is.
What do you think it is?
He found out that Hugh Jackman wasn't in the movie, and he ripped out all of his hair.
He's like, I only got in this so I could meet Hugh
like,
Jackman.
The only reason people watch these movies.
What do you think it could actually be, though? What's so devastating that you would rip out your own hair? Because can't think of a single thing.
Other than Hugh Jackman not appearing in an X-Men movie, I think it probably has to do something with like Mystique or Magneto, because they're all buddies.
Or maybe it's like Apocalypse traps him in like a psychic torture nightmare.
He loses his psychic battle.
Yeah. Like maybe
and something.
Maybe he like
go
puts
back.
Him in like some kind of psychic prison, and where he just constantly sees like the death of his friends or something. Or sees
well,
the
think
world
about this.
Exploding over
like,
and over again.
We know that that Mystique takes over at some point.
For some reason, which is
for
we-
some
I thought,
reason,
I thought
which
weird too.
Could be connected to why he's super upset.
That could very
like
well
he's
be.
Too broken. He can't lead them at this time.
Like or maybe what happens is
like
that
a bunch
he,
of people died.
Maybe what happens is that Apocalypse makes him think that he's seeing everyone die in this battle, and then he pulls out his hair because. Here's the thing, though, is that is pulling out your hair really a reaction that anyone has when something bad happens?
I pulled my hair once. Nothing came out, though.
Okay. But you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
I can't think of... I think most people just,
I feel
like
I usually want to, like, punch a wall or something.
Yeah, or
like
scream
that.
Or something. No one, like, pulls out their own hair. That's, like, that's weird.
Maybe. Because we know... We have now revealed that... Apocalypse is Stanley, and he's in charge of everything.
Maybe he's just bored,
and he's just making him pull out his own hair.
Yeah.
He's just, like, controlling him, and he's just
totally
laughing hysterically as he pulls out his own hair.
Totally.
One piece at a time.
That would be awful. Okay, so you ready
Maybe
to
he gets metal in his arms, and Magneto's doing it to him, because he's cruel. Do you want to talk about Star Wars now?
Yeah, let's talk about Star Wars now. So next week... new Star Wars movie.
I have to wait till Monday to see it. Ugh.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
No spoilers.
Well, we'll do a we'll do a spoiler free review first.
I just won't watch it. I just won't listen to you. I'll just go see the movie.
Well, thanks for making me feel like what we do here is pointless.
It is.
Gee, thanks.
Just, hey, I'm doing it too, so, I mean,
it's full circle. That's a good point. At least
I'm on IMDb still. I'm going to pull up Star Wars. Yep.
Okay, so...
Go through all three.
I guess we'll just start from the beginning of what we think about every one of these.
A New Hope.
A New Hope, or just Star Wars, depending on if you're, like, a weird Star Wars purist and are like, it wasn't originally A New Hope, and there weren't numbers, and it was, you know... Who cares? Who really cares about all of that? I don't get why anyone really cares.
We're just throwing this out there. When they released Episode 5, it did say Episode 5. Like, they had it planned.
Okay. All right. Interesting.
But after that, it was originally just Star Wars, so.
Yeah.
And Han shot first. We'll get to that.
Yeah. Okay, so in this movie, I have such vague memories of this 'cause this was I haven't watched this in so long. I mean, I remember the plot, of what happens.
I'm on IMDb. I will read you the plot.
Okay. You don't have to read me the plot, but
Luke Skywalker joins forces with a Jedi Knight, a cocky pilot, a Wookiee, and two droids to save the universe from the Empire's world-destroying battle station, while also attempting to rescue Princess Leia from the evil Darth Vader.
now, let's talk about how absolutely anti-feminist the idea of Princess Leia being. No, I'm just.
You know what? It's also offensive to short people because they say that Luke is too short to be a stormtrooper. Like, there's a height requirement to be a short stormtrooper.
I don't. What? No.
That's
Like,
heightist.
when. That's totally just made up by someone who didn't like the fact that he looked too short. And also,
I
what was he? What
don't
was? What were they gonna do then? What else were they gonna do? You know?
know. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
It's a classic line.
Yeah.
This thing is full of classic lines. It's a classic.
Yeah. Okay. So, the part I remember most is that fight with Darth Vader and Obi-Wan Kenobi. I think that's the thing I remember most out of this movie.
That's a lame fight. Like, considering the fight they had in episode three.
I mean, well, the in episode well, of course in episode three, I mean it looks cooler, but if you look also in episode three, that fight looks ridiculous too,
It
because they're like
does.
spinning around and
You know what the
blocking
problem
their
was in this one?
what?
Obi-Wan couldn't get to the high ground. Like,
That's exactly what the
yeah.
problem was. But you know what's weird? Okay, I
He was
talked about
just trying
this.
to find high ground and he couldn't, and Darth Vader just hit him and
Okay,
was
so
done.
on last week's podcast, I talked about this, but do you remember that, okay, in episode one, The Phantom Menace, Obi-Wan Kenobi is hanging in that pit beneath Darth Maul, and he wins, even though he doesn't have the high ground. How the heck does that make sense? Like,
Because
it's
they knew
Ewan
that
McGregor?
Obi-Wan,
It's
they
Ewan
put
McGregor?
themselves in a situation to kill Obi-Wan, and then they remembered that he's in episodes 4, 5, and 6, and then they're like, oh great, now we have to get him out of this.
See, that's the
So
problem
they
with George
made
Lucas's
something up.
writing. That's George Lucas's writing right there.
He just
Same, it's
remembered. He's like, oh
that's
great, this guy was
you
actually a
gotta remember.
character.
We gotta all remember that this is the same guy who decided that the words "Misa coming with you" or whatever. That's the same
Sounded
person who
good, like,
wrote though
thought that
that.
it fit in the s story.
Yeah. Just why? I don't get it. They're okay. Continuing on. But here's the thing: is that Obi fight with Obi-Wan. A, I don't get why he let himself die.
Yeah, he totally let
Okay.
himself, like.
I mean, okay, here's the thing. I know the answer that everybody wants to say is that, well, that's so that way he could come back as a blue ghost and then help Luke and could never be separated by him. But
Could
was
not have
he.
helped him with like an earpiece, like they could have been wearing headphones like we're doing right now.
Yeah.
And he could
Like,
have just
it's.
been there.
Yeah, and here's the thing I don't get is
Use the
that.
Force.
By doing this, let me ask you this. When does Obi-Wan teach Luke the Force?
He
At any
doesn't.
point as a ghost? He
He never
doesn't.
does.
He doesn't. He just tells him, hey, do this, do that. And I mean, the only time he really helps him out with the Force is when he blows up the Death Star and goes, use the Force. But that's
That's when he's a
like,
blue ghost.
yeah, like that. But that thing is, that's not even
He didn't really
like.
use the force, he just shot a missile.
What, well, you know, like, well, actually,
Pretty much.
something. Do you know that, okay, so you know how Darth Vader is such a good pilot? And
Is very good
well,
pilot.
the reason for that is because he uses the Force to control his ship. So, like, it's like he.
Yeah.
So the idea is that he uses. Lets the Force control his hands. So that way it'll just. He, like, he can dodge anything. At least almost
Yeah.
anything. Like, anything, that's
Well,
possible.
yeah.
But so. What do you think of the general story of this? This first one, just the fact that it's like go to a ship, save a princess, and then get, the plans for the it's the plans for the Death Star, right? That's in
Yeah.
R2-D2 that they're trying to
Okay, well, here's the thing. Have you seen the original trailer for this movie?
No, I have not.
Because it's absolutely ridiculous and it looks
Isn't it
horrible.
like supposed, don't they play it up to be like an actual like action adventure sci-fi
It's
thing?
hilariously bad. Like, my dad did not want to go see this movie because of how bad the trailer was. And then he saw an article in a magazine that was like, oh, the best movie of the century. He's like, okay, I'll go see it. And he loved it. So, but I mean, it's like a, I feel like Star Wars is hard to break down because it's such a classic.
Yeah, it's and here's
Like,
the thing. There's a lot of like various different kinds of metaphors and symbolism and all sorts of weird, crazy stuff. You could just like you could analyze Star Wars for years.
well, we could do
Years
it for a
and just
sociology class.
you really could.
Somebody could.
Yeah. Like, okay, I
People who
once
take sociology could do that.
yeah. Like I once told somebody how in many ways the original Star Wars is a lot like it's supposed to be kind of, and I don't think that like George Lucas plans, but it reminds me in a lot of ways of how World War II went, if you think about it. You know, like, okay, in some ways I think that like Darth Vader was kind of supposed to be like Hitler in a lot of ways, because if you
Wouldn't
think about it,
Hitler
right?
be more like Hitler?
Well, here's the reason that made me think that
Or
is that
Stalin?
A, so you know how like in World War II people thought that you know Hitler was going to be the next big leader for Germany and was going to be awesome and you know everybody loved him at first and stuff like that. Well, didn't you know you think about it like everybody thought that Anakin was going to be the chosen one, and then he turns out to be the biggest bad guy ever.
Pretty much
You
ever,
know?
yeah.
And then you're kind of cracking up, by the way.
Sorry.
And then he, you know, becomes he creates an entire empire where there are loyal soldiers that will do anything for him and all wear these big uniforms and just kill anybody that he asks them to. And also you think about it like, you know, like Hitler could literally kill anybody on a whim if he wanted to. And I kind of thought that that was supposed to sim that was a I might be to I'm probably totally overanalyzing this, but if you think about it, it's a lot like his forced choke. How anybody he doesn't like, he can just force choke them and they're dead with like a wave of his hands. Kinda. You know?
Yeah.
I might just be totally an overanalyzing this.
I
Anyway,
think you are, but
I probably
it's
am.
like a good idea,
Yeah. It's
kind
it. I
of.
think it's interesting. Anyway, okay. Is that all we want to talk about New Hope? 'Cause this
I
is the
like A
one
New Hope.
this is the
Overall, good movie. Watch it.
I think it is. I think it's a bit slow though. Don't you?
It can
It's a
be, but
bit.
I feel like Star Wars is hard to get into if you aren't watching it from an early age.
Yeah.
Like,
Oh
I feel
yeah.
like people who watch it for the first time as like adults think it's all like super dumb and everything.
Yeah, I can definitely
Feel
see
like a
that.
lot of Star Wars is sentiment, but I still love it.
Yeah.
So,
I
we
think
love your
everybody
Star
has a
Wars.
moment when they first introduce Star Wars that really clicks with them. And that's the point when they're like, I love Star Wars, you know? It's just kind of a thing where it when it happens, it's just you love it forever, you know? Like you're never not
Yeah.
gonna love it.
Can we
Okay,
talk
so
about Empire Strikes Back?
yes, okay, this is
Because
my
that is
f
my favorite.
this yes, this is my favorite too, just because everything in it is so cool, and this is like that movie probably defined everything that everyone remembers about Star Wars, if you think about it. You know, because it's got the
Like,
line of Luke, I am your father, and it's got, okay, no,
no,
and Anakin,
it's not possible.
and then Luke gets his hand chopped off.
He does?
Yeah, remember? His hand gets chopped off.
No, I said yes.
Oh,
Like,
okay.
yeah,
Oh,
he
okay.
does.
I thought you said it does.
Yeah, no, I
like you
remember
forgot
that.
about
I
that.
remember that part.
I'm
I
like,
was wondering what that glove
that's
was
kind
in
of hard. That's
episode
kind of
6.
hard to remember. Forget a dude getting his hand chopped off.
And his lightsaber with it. Like,
Yeah,
yeah, it's
too.
nice.
Which in the Force
Which is
Awakens
probably that's
trailer,
what.
we see that same lightsaber in the Force
Yeah.
Awakens trailer. So that will be. I'm curious what that will be
All
going
right.
on.
I have an idea. Now, this has been done before in the movie Sharknado 2. I watched this movie, and in the opening of this movie, the girl has a gun, and a shark eats her hand with the gun. And then in the last scene of the movie, her hand has been replaced with like a saw, and the shark
What
comes
is
down, and
this,
she.
Evil Dead?
No, this is Sharknado 2.
I know, but it sounds just like Evil Dead, where the dude gets his hand replaced with a chainsaw.
It gets better. So then a shark comes flying down at her, and she throws her hand up and cuts the shark open, reaches in, and pulls out her hand with the gun. Like, pulls out the gun with her hand still attached to it.
So what you're saying is going to happen
is that
Kylo Ren is going to eat Luke Skywalker's hand, his severed hand, from all those years ago. Like,
this was like probably no.
30 years
like
ago. And like then, a tauntaun then,
or something is just walking around down there and eats the hand with the lightsaber.
So you're saying
and then in the last scene of this movie, they cut open a tauntaun to put somebody inside and they find Luke's hand with the lightsaber.
So, okay, so what you're saying is that the last scene of this movie, we're going to see that there has been a tauntaun running around in those air vents of Cloud City.
No, it totally fell down to Cloud City. Like, it's like it felt they were on like a ship, weren't they?
Yeah, but it was like in the it was, you know, they were in like the open sky. Like it was like in
you know, it found ground somewhere. It found and a tauntaun ate it. Or like an Ewok or something, I don't know. Something ate it, and at some point we're gonna see his hand still attached to it.
The Ewoks find it and they worship it forever.
True. It's like their new master is his hand on this lightsaber.
Yeah. Okay, so I think that what do you think about the Hoth, everything that happens in Hoth in that movie? What'd you think about that?
Pretty good.
It's pretty good, isn't it?
It is pretty good.
It's pretty good. Okay, so I gotta say something about this. This is with like every Star Wars movie. Luke Skywalker is not a very good Jedi.
He's the lead.
Okay, for real though, think about it.
He's supposed to be the greatest ever, isn't he?
In the something book, like I feel like in the books though he is, but in this, in like the movies, what is okay in the movies? Think about it. What does he really do that's impressive?
He is a good pilot.
That's it.
No, he does. He buys some droids. He fixes droids in the first one. He complains a lot.
He does complain a lot.
Oh, I wanted to go to Tosche Station and shut it up. No, I love Luke. We love you. Mark Hamill, if you're listening to this, we love you.
I have to go help my friends on Cloud City. What about, what, training? No, yes, man, I'm good.
Can we talk about his training with Yoda, please, at some point? Because that's like the classic.
That's great. Yoda.
Yoda is fantastic.
Beautiful.
Yoda. I love that. Just... It's like revolutionary.
It was. I mean, did Jim Henson have something to do with that? Or was that...
I think he did.
Okay.
Frank Oz did the voice, though, I believe.
Yeah, because...
Who I think he also plays Miss Piggy in the Muppets.
Okay, that might make sense. Yeah, they do sound the same, now that I think about Miss
Piggy. They kind of do, so... Yoda. Yoda's, like, one of the most... to me, is one of the classic cinema characters.
I think he is, too.
I think he's great.
Like, I think it's... The thing is that he may... Either him or Darth Vader would be the most iconic character in Star Wars that there is. I think Darth Vader might be more iconic, though. You know,
but I mean, like, Yoda's, like kids, especially, I feel like, love Yoda.
Oh, yeah. Kids,
like,
I mean,
he's funny, and then he's, like, a super amazing Jedi, and nobody knows it.
There is no try, there is only do.
Yeah, do or do not. There is no try.
Oh, that
and he's like right. Super wise too. I mean, like
he's like 900 years old.
Here's my problem though. he's supposed to be about 900.
Yeah.
So, and that means that in the prequels he's about 800 and something, and he's doing all those crazy CGI flips. Dude, you're 800 like. Settle down.
Okay, here's another
thing. Take it easy.
Here's another thing, though. Why is it that in the prequels, you know, he's roughly a little less than 900 years old, and he can do CGI flips and everything, but in the, you know, the original movies, he's old and frail and can barely do anything. He can barely move. Yeah, he dies. And it's like, what?
And I cry.
And like, dude, think about it. How much further in the future are those apart?
It's about 20 years.
So it can't possibly be like
he's not that, yeah. But
I think it's a little bit over
in those movies, 20
years though, isn't it?
In those, it's about 20 years. Luke's about 20 something.
Yeah, but think about it. Like Vader's really old though.
like he is.
And so is Obi-Wan.
But I mean,
but we don't necessarily
he
know.
He could have been
Anakin's,
like, how old is Anakin? He could have been like
30,
46. But
I would
he's been
say,
living
I would say at the
a
end.
Team.
I would say Anakin's in the third movie. Anakin's probably like what?
He's been
early thirties to late twenties. I would say.
Yeah.
Right, because he's got that long hair, man.
He does.
Those yellow
eyes. You
can't grow
hair like that until you're about 30.
You gotta be a real man before you can get locks like those.
That's like the first thing that everybody thinks when they turn 30, like, now I can have sweet hair.
Now I can have those freaking locks, man.
Yep.
Okay, so...
I have somebody else that I would like to talk about.
Okay.
Do you want to keep talking about Yoda? Because I have one other person I want to talk about.
No, go ahead. Who do you want to talk about? Is it Lando?
Lando.
Lando Calrissian.
Because he's awesome.
He is, dude. He's like... Okay, he is like a jazz club owner.
Have you seen his mustache?
His mustache, dude, is glorious.
His mustache is amazing.
Is the best facial hair in this entire movie, in all the movies, in Star Wars movies.
He's like the only facial hair, so yes.
I think, yeah.
Obi-Wan has a beard, which is pretty good, but it's not awesome. Like,
it's not quite as good as the mustache.
Not quite as good as the mustache. You know who he reminds me of?
Who?
It's Apollo Creed. And
yeah, dude, he does. He is a lot like Apollo
like
Creed.
Star Wars version of Apollo Creed.
You're cutting out.
Did you see a new Creed movie?
I have not seen it. You're cutting out a little bit. I have not seen the new Creed movie.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, I heard
Michael B. Jordan. Good.
I heard that people are saying that Stallone is like could win an Oscar for it.
He could. He's very good.
Okay.
And I think that
go see that movie.
Michael B. Jordan's pretty good as well.
Cool. Cool.
He's got some serious muscles, some good abs.
Yeah.
But his mustache is pretty weak.
Wait, he gets a mustache in this?
He's got a little bit of a mustache. Like, it's like a... It's kind of like a... I don't know. It's not as cool as Apollo Creed or Lando's.
Yeah.
Okay, that's where we just came from. Anyway. Lando's awesome.
Yeah. This is also the first movie where we see Boba Fett.
Mm-hmm.
Here's the thing, all right? I love Boba Fett. But he is almost not in this movie at all.
He's really not as cool as everybody thinks he is.
Here's what I think happens, and this is exactly what happened with Darth Maul, if you think about it. I think what happened was that he got no lines, he looked really cool, and died super quick. So people were like, okay, we got to fill in his story now.
Yeah.
Because he's super cool. You know, like, okay.
It's basically because he looks cool. Like, did you see how lame he was in Return of the Jedi? He flies into the side of the ship and gets eaten by a big monster.
Okay.
That probably also ate Luke's.
We'll talk about how he dies because it's ridiculous, really, what happens. But, but in this movie, also, why the heck is Boba Fett hanging out with Darth Vader all the time? Because you know when Darth Vader's at that dinner table and they walk in and they're like, oh no, it's a trap. Not Admiral Akbar scene. But
long movie. Which one is that?
That's Return of the Jedi.
That's what I thought.
But, why is Boba Fett there? Like, he doesn't need to protect Darth Vader. I don't get why it is anyone's ever...
Cool.
I don't get why anyone's ever like, okay, Darth Vader needs bodyguards. When does Darth Vader ever need protection from anybody? Ever.
Well, we don't know this, but Lando's mustache does have pretty cool powers, and he could probably defeat Darth Vader without protection.
We should also talk though about the Imperial ranking system that they have, which is basically
who looks the coolest.
No, it's basically if you mess up your mission, you get force choked, and the dude below you gets promoted. which is insane.
You know,
how does the Empire survive like that, though? Like, how?
Because they have a lot of people.
I guess so, but why? Why do so many people join the Empire? I think...
So they don't get force-choked.
Well, I actually read have you read any of the Star Wars books before?
Like, parts of them.
There are some really good ones. I can recommend you a couple. But I was reading Allegiance, which is a really good one. It's about...
Heard of it?
It's some stormtroopers who... go rogue and run from the Empire. But basically, they think... And I mean, I get this isn't, technically
Star Wars
canon. Isn't
that pretty much John Boyega's character in the new one? Is that his name?
It could be, but this was written much earlier, before any of this.
I mean, it could be, like, based off of it.
It could be. It could be, at least, it's, I think it will probably be influenced at least a little bit. But in that movie, it talks a lot about how, you know, everybody thinks the Empire is awesome. Like, that's why anyone joins the Empire, because they think, you know, it's, you know, I'm serving.
Because they have the coolest costumes.
Well, they also think, you know, it's like, you know, their duty because it's their country and, well, you know, not country, but their empire. But so I think that's probably the reason that so many people join. But anyway, okay, let's get to the real meat, the heart of the matter, all right?
Okay.
Which is the lightsaber fight in the Carbonite Room.
Which is pretty cool.
It is, okay, I watched that movie pretty recently. It is one of the coolest lightsaber fights. I think it's the coolest one.
In Star Wars.
I think it's the coolest one. But the one that could also compete is the Darth
Vader.
Their
Maul fight in, I was going to say Luke versus Darth Vader in Return of the Jedi is pretty sweet. It's kind of like Christmas with the red and the green.
Yeah, you could say that. Although I really like the fact that in this, it seems much more strict. In all these original movies, I love the fact that they look, that when they fight, they're fighting as though they realize, I could chop my own arm off with this.
Yeah.
Whereas in the prequel movies, they're just like, I'm going to flip my sword around and I'm going to flip over your head and chop your head off. You wouldn't do that.
Don't try to verify anything in the prequel movies.
I know. But, you know, like one reason why I love this fight is because it looks, like, if you notice, they hold their lightsabers really far apart from one another, and they don't go hurling them at each other. They're just like, you know, whack.
Like, and I would not want to be close to somebody with a lightsaber, even if I had a lightsaber. I would want to, like you,
and
I'm staying away from that. And I still feel like they aren't trying to hit each other's lightsabers.
Yeah.
Which oftentimes that's what it looks like in movies.
Yeah.
With swords and stuff.
Yeah, it kind of looks more like they're dancing most of the time in choreography with swords.
It looks cool, it doesn't look brutal.
Yeah, like, okay, like, I think a good example of fighting choreography is The Matrix. You've seen The Matrix before?
Matrix 4?
The first one, just the
parts.
Okay, well, if you've seen the end fight in the train, in the subway, you should at least watch that part. It's some really great choreography in that.
I'll watch it soon.
Okay. But, you know, like, I think that also in that scene, it really shows how Luke isn't a Jedi and, like, isn't trained.
He's really not.
And he's really, like, it's really showing that he just doesn't really, he's not qualified to fight somebody like Darth Vader. You know, like, his fear and worry is just showing all on his face. And you can even tell also that Darth Vader's just going easy on him. Because he can't win, and that he's his son, and he doesn't want to just kill him.
He also knows. So it's kind of
like the whole scene is him just toying with Luke. Mm-hmm. You know, like I think he even says sometimes that, you know, Obi-Wan taught you. That's when he says, Obi-Wan taught you well, right? When he's fighting him.
I think so. He taught me better. That's what he should have said.
Yeah, but you know what I mean? Is that he taught me better. At least you didn't get burned alive and have all your limbs chopped off.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I feel like you only lost
a hand.
Obi-Wan could totally beat Darth Vader again.
That's the thing. Why didn't he? Why didn't he just kill him?
Because Luke is the main character and he has to do it.
But here's the thing. Nobody tell me it's because of some freaking destiny that Luke has to defeat the Emperor or whatever.
Could he maybe, like, weaken Darth Vader? Like,
okay, why couldn't he have at least chopped Darth Vader's hand or something off again?
Well, he's a robot. Like, he could have. Like, here's what he does. But he says, he chops off his hand, says, takes his lightsaber, says, Luke, have at it. Your destiny. Luke does it.
But here's the thing. Why did Obi-Wan think, okay, Luke will have to win because destiny worked so great out with Anakin?
Yeah.
You know? Like, there was no guarantee that he wasn't going to join the dark side too.
He really isn't.
Offered it, like, you know?
Yeah, it's like a tempting offer.
It really is. I mean, he says, "Hey, if you join me, we can kill the Emperor, and the galaxy will be awesome, and it'll just be, you and me."
That's when you take his help, and
That's
then
when you
you
take his
turn around
help.
and kill him after he
Yeah,
helps you kill the
you
Emperor.
kill the Emperor,
Then you
then you
kill
kill
Darth
Darth Vader.
Vader.
Then you're like, "All right, Princess Leia, Han Solo, here you go. I'm gonna go be a monk and make more Jedi."
Exactly.
Dude,
Like,
that
where's
see,
that?
that's the thing I never get is that it's I always feel like it's weird in movies where it's like the good guy can never just say that they're gonna do something and then just lie. Like I feel like it's always weird when that happens, don't you? When it's like the
Yeah.
hero has to tell the truth, or it's not like he can
Well, I
lie
think
about it.
that's part of what makes them a hero. Like, that's kind of a hero
I
quality,
can
honestly.
kind of get it. And I guess also that, the writer has to put them in a situation that's difficult for them to get out of.
I
And
feel
so,
like,
if you just make it so that, oh, they can lie, then.
in a lot of really good movies, the good guys are actually not very good guys. Like, they kind of
Yeah.
like break the law a lot. Like Inception,
Like Inception.
the whole team is kind of outlaws.
And
That's an
totally like
amazing movie.
violates, and their job is literally like violating people's minds. So,
Yes,
I
but
mean,
it's a great movie.
it
One of
is
my
a
favorites.
fantastic
One of
movie.
my
One of
favorite
my favorite
movies.
movies, yes, all of all time. Pulp Fiction, also one of my favorite movies of all time. Great movie too. Anyway, so lightsaber fight is awesome. Luke gets his hand chopped off. Princess Leia and Luke kiss. Now here's the thing, as we're
Awkward.
going into this, I think that
Awkward.
they didn't plan, they must have not planned, right? That
Yeah.
Luke was going to be his
There's
sister.
no
Because
way.
otherwise, I mean, I can't imagine, especially in the 70s, dude, like, oh, let's have this incestual relationship in our, sci-fi adventure movie. Like, they couldn't have been like, yeah, that's an awesome idea. Like, from the
Yeah, I feel
beginning,
like
there's no way they could pull
they
that
probably
off.
forgot that they had them kiss when they decided to, and then they like go back and watch the other ones, and they're like, oh, great.
I think they didn't want, I think they were like, okay, everybody just forget that that ever happened,
Yeah.
Because then this one also, Han Solo totally does fall in love with Leia, and
Completely.
I think that's probably more of them trying to cover it up that, never happened, guys. Don't
Yep,
worry
not at
about it.
all. Can we, all right, so summarize.
So, Luke,
Yoda, great.
yep, Yoda, awesome lightsaber fight.
Everything on Hoth, great.
Hoth's cool.
Lando's mustache, great.
Yep. Luke's a horrible Jedi.
He's not that good.
He's really not. Darth Vader just wants to hang out with his son, and his son hates him.
Yeah, that stinks. That
And
really
Luke gets
does.
his hand chopped off because of that. That's
Yeah, he's
fatherly
like,
discipline,
take
okay?
this. I'll teach you to disrespect me, son.
Yeah, don't disrespect your father. Chop your hand
Chop.
off. Yeah. Okay. The final movie, Return of the
Last
Jedi.
one.
This one is probably the second best Star Wars movie, I think, out of all of them. What
Pretty
do you
good.
think? Yeah, I think so. A lot of stuff happens in this. Okay, so this even this movie, right? This is supposed to be where Luke has finished his training and is a full-fledged Jedi.
And he
I
gets a
don't.
really cool black outfit.
Yeah, I don't feel like he's that good still, though. Do you?
He's pretty good in the
He's better
first
than he
scene when
was.
he.
He's better than he was in Empire Strikes Back, but
He does a
not.
flip, so that's pretty
Yeah,
good.
he doesn't flip. Yeah, but I felt like like he didn't really do very well. Like I
He
feel like
did.
the
He won. That's good enough, right?
Well, yeah, but like okay, an example is that he let himself get captured by Jabba the
He did. He did do
Hutt.
that. But he
Ow,
totally
my throat.
got out of it.
True, but with others' help. Like I feel like he, if a like a good Jedi, would have been able to just go in there and be like, "Listen, what is it they want anyway? They want Han Solo back? Is that it?"
Yeah, Luke wants Han Solo back. They do wind
Okay,
up getting him
he
back.
could have just been like, "Okay, give me Han Solo back, or else I'll just, I'll
You know what
totally
he could
take
have
you, I'll
done?
totally take you down, man."
I feel like Jabba the Hutt would not be that hard to take down.
He okay,
What is he gonna
Leia
do?
kills him with a chain. And
Cut him
chokes him to
open.
death.
Cut him open in hand, and Luke's hand with the
Oh,
lightsaber comes out.
you're cutting out really bad.
Am I?
Okay, you're good now.
Am I good?
Yeah, you're good. But yeah. Yeah, you're right about the whole, you know, it would be easy to kill Jabba the Hutt.
Not that hard.
I don't get how it is that he survived this long. You think about it? How did he survive this long? How did no one just, like, literally anyone could just walk in there, shoot him, run out. That's it.
Boba Fett. He's kind of protected, though.
Yeah, but, you know, I feel like somebody could have killed all those guards. Like, they also, all the guards just have axes. They don't have guns.
My question is, why has he not died of heart trouble? Like, have you seen how big this guy is?
Oh, yeah, man.
He's huge.
I can't even imagine. And also, here's another thing. Are they naturally that way, or did he just decide, hey, I'm never going to move again, and I'm just going to be fat forever?
I mean, he moves a little bit, really slowly. Like,
yeah, but you know what I mean. You know, like, is it like all of his species are naturally that sized, or is it just that he's just an abnormally fat Hutt?
I don't know, and I don't really care.
Okay,
to be honest,
same.
Like,
okay, so
they're fat. That's cool. Stop.
Okay, so that's the cool. Rancor is in this. Is the Rancor, the giant monster thing that Luke fights and kills.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Luke kills it. Yep. Good.
That's just because they're trying to show that he's cool now.
Yep.
He does a front flip.
Boba Fett literally just stands while most of this happens and nods at things.
Then he flies into the side of a ship and dies.
Okay, we'll get to that. We'll get to that in a second.
Okay.
Leia gets enslaved.
She does.
That
does happen.
A bunch of so have you heard the recent controversy about that?
Mm.
What they've done, been doing?
Mm-mm.
Okay, so Disney is now said that they are not going to sell that outfit anymore anywhere or merchandise it or anything.
Probably a good thing.
Well, I guess as a business decision is. I mean, I just think it's, you know, kind of dumb. It doesn't really matter. But I think that what the thing is that some people did find it controversial, and then, you know, they were like, well, we want to make money, so better just destroy controversy than, you know, just, you know, pick a side on it.
Right? I feel like it's not very family friendly.
Well, yeah. But, you know, I mean, I think I think this is the reason that why they did that, though, is because she's now technically a Disney princess.
She is.
You know?
So have you seen Jasmine from Aladdin? Pretty much the same thing.
True. Except they didn't really change her outfit, though.
No, they didn't.
Although I think it's the fact that the outfit is called Slave Leia that kind of
can't support slavery.
Yeah. Like,
freedom.
You know, yeah. Okay, I heard somebody, I was listening to another podcast about this, and I had never thought about this before, but someone brought this up. I never thought about this. Let me ask you, did you ever think that Jabba the Hutt, like, sexually assaulted Leia during
any No.
I didn't think that either. I heard somebody say, though, that might have happened, but I don't think that could
have. I don't want that.
Yeah. I don't think that's a physical possibility. Mm. And two, it kind of just seems like she's just quietly sitting there.
She doesn't seem
outraged or anything, you know?
Yeah.
And also, I don't think she would just let, you know, like, I feel like she was, you know, she's a strong person. She wouldn't, you know, she'll put up a fight.
I mean, she wasn't even there that long.
Yeah.
Like a few days.
But here's the thing about that outfit, though, that a lot of people, I think, and it's mostly what happens to her that a lot of people disagree with, but she does, like, kill Jabba the Hutt at the end of that.
Hmm.
And, like, chokes him to death. You know?
True. That is true.
Whatever.
I feel like that's probably because he's not a good dude.
Yeah, probably also because he's literally just a giant fat slug monster that can't move. Okay,
also,
anyway.
Can we get to Luke's flip?
Oh, yeah, that crazy weird
Luke
flip.
He does a flip, and I just wanted to bring that out
and,
again.
Okay, if R2-D2 had not been there, Luke would have died. That's simply, he would have died.
I feel like that flip would be a good Jedi, though.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good. It was a good flip.
I don't know. It was a pretty good flip, like a 9 out of 10 star flip.
Like a nine out of 10. I would agree with that. Okay, now
it'd be like an 8 and a half.
Boba Fett gets killed. Here's the dumb thing I hate about
how
he gets killed. All right, so what happens if you watch the clip? All right,
he jetpacks into the side.
No. Here's what happens. All right. So Chewbacca yells to blind, you know, like Han Solo's still like blind from being in carbonite and stuff.
Yeah.
Well, Chewie yells to Han and goes, and then Han Solo goes, Boba Fett, where? And then he turns around with a big stick in his hand and hits Boba Fett's jetpack, which activates it, hits him into the side of the ship, then he falls into the pit. That is the dumbest writing I have ever heard of in all of history. Like, that had to have been just George Lucas, right? Like, there was no editing in that.
I feel there like
couldn't have been.
That was written, they had a deadline to finish that scene, and they wrote it at 3 a.m.
Yeah, probably. You're probably right. Because like, otherwise, cause
how
like,
are we going to get rid of him?
They must have known at that point that he was Honto a popular character, right?
He probably wasn't that popular.
Well, that's right, because he only had, like, what? Three scenes.
He didn't really have a line. Like, yeah. But stood around and was like, whatever.
Yeah.
And so he's really not that cool.
He only fights too in Return of the Jedi.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like for like a second.
Yeah.
But that's why we should be thankful of the Star Wars books, which just fill in all the character storylines from every character ever in Star Wars.
How much of that is canonical?
You mean like canon anymore? Yeah. Or I think, like, none of it.
Pretty much,
although, here's the thing. In the Star Wars comic books, which are canon now, Boba Fett does climb out of the pit.
He does
get out of there, yeah. And Darth Maul is alive.
And he finds Luke's lightsaber and the monster as well, with the hand attached.
Yeah, he's like, well...
Sharknado crossover.
I'll just go sell this now. but, okay, so... But, yeah, Boba Fett... He shouldn't have died. You know, like, I feel like, okay, in the books, from what I've heard, he's, like, awesome. Like, he's, like, the ultimate killing machine. And in this movie, he's just a
he's wuss. Kind of a loser.
He's a loser. That's really all he is. Anyway.
Not that good.
They escape. Everybody escapes. Jabba the Hutt dies. So then they go to Endor, right? That's the next thing that happens, basically.
Sure.
And there, how does Luke find out that he has that Leia's his sister? Isn't it like Obi-Wan tells him?
He kind of just figures it out.
Okay.
Like, he knows he has a sister, and then he just kind of like connects the dots, and he's like, oh.
And
I think he had like, a DNA test. He took a piece of hair from Leia,
and then
she ripped out,
and then
she
got
distressed.
I'm surprised that if in the real world, if he were to figure that out, and then he's like, and then he remembers Empire Strikes Back, he'd be like, oh.
That's when he rips out his hair. Big reveal at the end of the movie, he's bald.
Yep, he's bald. Yep, totally. So then they fight. Okay, they meet the Ewoks. Let's just get to the Ewoks.
Yay.
What do you think of the Ewoks? Because a lot pretty of people
cool.
hate the Ewoks.
They're pretty
a
good.
A lot of people really hate the Ewoks. I think they're fine.
They're good.
I think they just...
They're there.
Okay.
They help out.
They were designed to sell toys, too, because they just wanted a whole bunch of toys.
Well, I feel like they're the only reasonable Star Wars characters that you can get it as a stuffed animal.
That's also true. Although, what about R2?
He can't be stuffed. He's got to be plastic.
I suppose that is true. All the Ewoks worship C-3PO.
Mm-hmm. They hate Han Solo.
They hate Han Solo? I don't remember that. I guess they
Yeah, they try to they do. Rotisserie
they try
him.
To cook. They try to cook all of them.
Yeah.
They put them all on steaks. They do love Leia, though, don't they?
They do.
They even give her fancy clothes and
they definitely
everything.
Did.
And, yep. And then
and Luke helps him get out of that by using the Force.
Or something.
Because he's a Force master. Because remember, he makes C-3PO fly.
Oh, yeah, that's right. And so... Okay, so then they gotta, like, destroy a shield generator to blow up the second Death Star.
At least most of it, because it's not completely finished yet.
I think
there's a big chunk of it missing.
Why would you design a Death Star with the same flaw twice? Think about it. Like, okay. Because
the writers were working on this at 3 in the morning.
And they were like, okay, how can they blow up the Death Star? They just didn't think about it. the Imperials were just like, I'm sure nobody will actually try to go for the exhaust port again. I mean, you know, surely they'll think, you know, that we're smart enough for that. And then Lando blows it up in the Millennium Falcon, and then everybody's happy.
You know, you could do ask Stan Lee, because he's in charge of everything.
Oh yeah, man.
As we established earlier.
Stan Lee. Oh, you know who else is in charge of everything though? Then we find out that the Emperor. Guess what? Mm-hmm. All right, this is where it gets Stan really. Lee. No, the Emperor is Nick Offerman. What about that? What if that happened? He looks kind of like him, right? Dead. He looks kind of like him though.
He's dead.
But that would have been awesome if Nick Offerman was the Emperor.
It doesn't matter anymore. The Emperor's dead.
I know, but
Lando's mustache got to him.
He could come back as a red ghost. A red ghost.
Do they have those?
No.
I'd like to see a Star Wars movie that's just ghost fighting.
Yeah.
But they don't really do anything. It's just like a rap battle or something.
Okay, something else that makes me upset is that afterwards, after the prequels came out, George Lucas edited a bunch of stuff in these movies. So at the end of it,
it's Hayden Christensen.
Yeah, Hayden Christensen.
Nobody wants him.
Which, okay, here's another thing. None of the other people are young.
Yeah,
everybody
it's not
else
fair.
Is old.
Do you think they have a choice? Do you think they have a choice? And
but
so
that's dumb.
It's like, hey, do you want to be Alec Guinness or do you want to be Ewan McGregor? And he's like, I'll be Alec Guinness.
But who would do that?
I don't know.
Why would he not be Ewan McGregor? Because Ewan McGregor looks really cool.
He does. He looks very cool. He has a cool goatee.
Yeah, dude.
He's got great hair.
He's got great hair.
His hair is
and
amazing.
Fantastic lightsaber form.
He does. He's great.
Real fantastic lightsaber form. Anyway.
Hayden Christensen, he's got that hair that you get when you turn 30, but other than that.
Yeah, that hair that you get when you turn 30.
I feel like he just looks weird. Like, Luke wouldn't even be able to recognize him. Like, that's what he looked like before he had his arms chopped off and everything.
Okay, dude, this would have been also really cool. If you think about it, this would have made sense, too, for him to come back as, like, a white Darth Vader. Like, Darth Vader wearing white armor.
That's racist.
No. Okay, no. Get this, because there's actually a comic book where Darth Vader does have white armor. And he gets a blue lightsaber, and he goes to the light side again. That would have been cool, right?
That would have been pretty
cool. Imagine Obi-Wan and Yoda and just Darth Vader in white.
I want you to imagine Alec Guinness as Obi-Wan Kenobi with Ewan McGregor's hair.
Oh my gosh. That would be like a Will Ferrell moment.
Sure.
You know?
I
feel like it's something Will Ferrell would do.
Yeah.
Or
anyway,
Adam Sandler.
We've pretty much done. That's pretty much a Star Wars. We talked about best hair.
Yep.
Best facial hair.
We didn't talk about the fight at the end with Luke Skywalker.
Mm. Good fight.
And where? Yeah, it is.
A lot of electricity.
Yeah, there is.
Goes on
what
in that fight.
What did you think about the fact that ultimately Darth Vader is responsible for saving everybody?
It's his destiny.
I know, but isn't that sort of dumb?
Because
let me here's another thing. That scene where he goes where Luke is being electrocuted and Luke Skywalker's freaking out at this point and he's going
he's not doing very well.
He's really not doing well. And then Darth Vader goes, No, and then he picks up the Emperor and tosses him down like an air shaft or something.
He does do that, doesn't he?
Like a electric pylon. Dude,
cool.
Okay. Also, why the heck did he throw him? What?
As opposed to, like, using a lightsaber and just ending it?
Yeah. Like, I feel like, if the Emperor is supposed to be the strongest Sith Lord in the galaxy, he is a loser then. Because he didn't even, here's the thing.
But the thing is, he's not, Anakin is the strongest.
Well, here's the thing, right, is that in the Star Wars books, anyway, which, isn't canon, but, the Emperor is supposed to be that his thing is that he just knows everything. Like, he can sense all this stuff that's happening, which also we see in the movies, Because, you know, he senses that, you know, like, Luke Skywalker's out there and, you know.
He does.
He senses everything. You know, like, he even knows that he's Darth Vader's, that he's the father of Darth Vader.
He does know that, doesn't he?
Yeah, because he's the one who tells him, right? That
he is.
That, you know,
at he's the end, the, oh, he's the worst no in the whole.
Oh, yeah. No.
We'll have to rate some of these best to worst.
It was in the first in New Hope, remember? Because he goes, Luke Skywalker, the son of Anakin Skywalker is...
That's impossible. Yeah.
Yeah. But, something also that's weird about that. Why did he not go, I have a son? You mean that he lived? You mean that I'm actually still a father and that you lied
to
me?
Well, he says that that's impossible.
Yeah, but...
He really doesn't seem that upset about it.
Yeah, he doesn't seem upset about it at all. And then
he's kind of like, oh, really?
And then he's just like, okay.
Oh, that's cool. I'll go chop off his hand.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's the type of thing that goes through his
mind.
Which
I get it's supposed to be, you know, it's a big reveal in Empire Strikes Back that, oh.
It is. It's pretty cool.
It is. I couldn't imagine, dude, if I didn't know that before I watched that movie. You know, because, like, everybody knows.
Yeah.
You know, like, everybody knows the line, Luke, I am your father, that.
Yeah.
Like, could you imagine if you were in the theater?
You're seeing that for the first time.
And you just, like you must flip, like flip out. Because I don't think there's any mention of it before. Like, there's no referencing or foreshadowing.
No, there's no foreshadowing at all.
Like, it's just like, oh, whoa. He was a Jedi and he, oh. And then it's just everything clicks.
Mm-hmm.
And so, but the worst, you're right, the worst no in Star Wars is when he finds out that Padme has lost the will to live and...
You killed her.
In your anger. In which case, why would
best
he not
no.
leave? And also, why would he not leave at that point? What more does he have to gain? Because Padme's dead. That's the whole reason he became a Sith Lord. It is just, prequels are garbage. In all honesty, I think people just shouldn't watch them.
They shouldn't. Those should be what's no longer canon.
Yeah.
Like it would be we just pretend that that never happened?
Like, think about how great it would have been if they weren't canon anymore.
I haven't watched those in years, so I really don't care either.
I don't care. I mean, it doesn't really matter. Any final thoughts on Return of the Jedi?
Good movie.
It is a good movie.
Luke has a cool black outfit.
Yes, he does. That's probably... Is that his most iconic outfit, I think?
I think his most iconic outfit is the one that he wears in A New Hope, because that's what's on the big poster and everything.
That's true. That's
kind of like a big V-neck.
The weird, like, robe kind of.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
The weird robish outfit. Does anything else happen that we missed? They destroy the shield generator and then blow up the Death Star, and oh, it's a trap. Admiral Ackbar. That is, okay, Admiral Ackbar is one of the greatest Star Wars characters ever. Almost purely because of that line.
Just because of his face. He's got a great face.
Dude, he's a puppet too, right?
I think so.
He must have been. Man, they got some. They do some really great puppetry in these movies, by the way.
Mm-hmm. Yoda dies.
Yes, Yoda dies.
Sad.
There's so many things, though, that if you think about it, really don't make sense in this movie. Like, why could Yoda not live a little bit longer and go help him?
He lost the will to live.
Of course, yeah, he lost the will to live. You know what? The Emperor lost the will to live, too. That's why he fell off. Fell off the pylon thing and died.
What's the best no in the series? I'm saying episode 5, when he finds out that...
When he goes, no!
It's not possible. Yeah,
it's not true! Yeah. You're lying! He basically just acts like a whiny little brat in that scene, you know?
That's pretty much what Luke is. Like, he's a great character, but he is kind of a whiny little brat.
Which I think they were going for with Hayden Christensen. Because he's so freaking whiny and hates everything and is like...
Jake Lloyd, who plays him in the first one, he's pretty bad too. I think he went to jail a couple months ago.
Oh, yeah. I think he did too. but dude, Hayden Christensen, all of the... I should be a Jedi Master if I'm going to be on the Council. I don't want to be on the Council if I can't be a Jedi Master.
Shut up.
And all of the... Oh, dude, I talked to the Slow Spawn, my other co-host, about this last week, where he kills all the Tusken Raiders and then goes to Padme and goes, I killed them. with not just the men, but the women and the children too. They're animals. So I slaughtered them like animals. Who would stay with that guy? He's a psychopath.
Literally nobody.
He's a literal psychopath in those movies. In every sense of the word, is a total psychopath.
He's pretty bad.
I hate it, just on every level, hate his performances. Although, let me ask you this. What part of it do you think was his acting, and what part of it do you think was the writing? Because he has horrible lines. Like lines that really no one could pull off very well.
I feel like it's bad writing. And
him confused on what to do.
And him, like, not knowing how you're supposed to deliver those lines. Like, how are you supposed to take those lines seriously?
Maybe, in all honesty, maybe he did the best that anyone could. You know, do you think that someone could have done it better? Is there any actor that you think could have played him better?
Shia LaBeouf. No, I'm just kidding.
He actually could have made
it pretty good. He could have actually done that. I say that as a joke because we were talking about him earlier, but I mean, I try not to think of anybody. I feel like nobody else would want to take that part. Like, I feel bad for him because that's what he's known for. Like, if he does anything good, it's not going to be remembered.
I heard something really funny. Oh, did you hear that Hayden Christensen is supposed to come back for the next Star Wars movie?
Please, no.
No, but like, here's the thing. I've heard that he's actually become a much better actor, And with good writing, you think about it, he might do well. Maybe.
Maybe. Who's he going to play?
Yeah, I heard that Liam Neeson, when he became Qui-Gon Jinn, that he didn't read any of the script. He just heard...
Big mistake.
No, he just heard Star Wars and was like, I have to do this. And then, oh boy, just...
Can you just imagine being super excited and then coming to the first read through and just being like, what on earth is this?
Yeah, dude. It's just...
As soon as you hear the first Jar Jar Binks line, you're just like, what did I get myself into?
He's gonna come with you, Qui-Gon.
And Liam Neeson is like, oh, great.
Have you seen the set photos for Phantom Menace? Everything is a blue screen.
It's pretty bad.
All that they're around is just a blue screen. That's it. There's no people they're talking to. And okay, here's another thing I hate about the prequels. All the clones are just CGI. Every single one ever in all of the movies. Was it really too expensive to hire a couple extras to just walk in a suit in a costume?
Yes. Apparently.
Apparently to George Lucas it was. I just love. And you know what? I heard George Lucas say that his favorite character is Jar Jar Binks.
That man, he is ill.
And you know what? Disney, when George Lucas brought that script, because, you know, George Lucas had written a script for the next trilogy, he brought it to Disney and they said no.
Oh.
They were so smart. And I'm so proud of Disney for doing such a thing.
Yeah.
Okay, now, everybody. We've been going for a long time. I think we might have gone over time, but I'm not sure.
Probably too long. Edit some of my nonsense out.
Yeah, thank you all for watching. Yeah, Star Wars. I will be doing a review with a couple other people.
I have a crazy schedule, so I probably won't.
Yeah, you probably won't. You better come back, though.
I might come back.
For something. You might.
Depends if there's popular demand. I don't know.
Everyone comment that you want Dave to come back.
Yes.
Well, thank you for coming on this podcast. I know how busy your life is that you know you could just barely fit me in. So
yes.
Yeah.
Sure.
Everybody, thank you for watching. I am Hole Puncher. This is Dave. He won't be back. Yay. He'll be back in a little.
Probably in about a year.
It better not be a year. It better be like 2 weeks or something.
I don't know. We'll see.
Anyway, Slow Spawn, I'm sure we'll be returning next week. No, maybe he won't be because we're going to be doing Star Wars and he probably won't want to be spoiled. I think he's going to wait to see it too for something. Anyway, goodbye.